Tonight at 6, as a massive storm makes its way toward the coast, workers here in central Ohio are heading right into the danger zone as the danger gets near the deep south.
Hurricane Laura is expected to make landfall tonight. A group of AEP frontline and tree cutters are hoping to provide some relief to the region. NBC4 Sean Lanier joins us now. And Sean, you spoke with one of those workers who will try to help out others during this time of crisis.
Yeah, that's right, Carrie. I spoke to one of the supervisors who says this is his third time going to help and volunteer during a hurricane with AEP. You know, they will leave tomorrow morning, head to Memphis, and they will stay there as the storm passes through, and then they'll head to Texas, pulling them away from their families. But they all tell me it's worth it.
You know, whether it be here, whether it be somewhere else, that's the beauty of the mutual assistance, is being able to travel around and help people all throughout the United States.
It's part of the job, but it's a job Jeffrey Terrell loves. He's part of the 400-man crew from AEP Ohio going to Longview, Texas. They're assisting their sister company SWEPCO restore power to the region after Hurricane Laura passes through.
We're expecting a lot of flooding, which means we'll probably have a lot of wire down, poles down with the wind.
But those are the least of their concerns on these kinds of assignments.
The biggest challenge is the heat.
They've been told the heat index in Longview, Texas is expected to get into the 100s, even though they'll be wearing long pants, shirts, hats, and masks. They're prepared for the heat and humidity.
We just got to take frequent breaks. You know, we keep bandanas in one cooler that'll stay nice and cold, and as soon as one starts to warm up, we'll move on to the next one.
This crew is expected to help for at least 2 weeks, and it's 2 weeks Terrell will be away from his four kids, who hide a handwritten note in his luggage every time he goes on these trips with a very special message.
I may not find it the first day. I may not even find it until the seventh or eighth day, but sooner or later I'll find a note from them, you know, telling me to be safe and telling me how proud they are of me.
And I did ask about the COVID-19 guidelines. They say that they are not too worried, but they are prepared with masks, hand sanitizer, keeping their social distance, making sure that they have cleaning supplies inside of the car as well. They're taking all precautions to make sure that they can better help people that need them at this time. Looking for you in Columbus, Sean Lanier, NBC4.